各位朋友们，歡迎各位來到今天這個纏繞行為刑事化的一個研討會。今晚這個研討會是由幾個團體一起合辦的，就包括了有國際特赦組織香港分會，還有就香港理工大學應用社會科學學系的社會政策研究中心，還有香港婦女中心協會一同合辦的。咁咧就其實喺呢一個舊年年尾十月度啦，咁政府咧就推出一個咧係關於纏繞行為刑事化嘅一個諮詢文件。咁樣當呢個諮詢文件推出咗之後咧，咁就各界咧都有好多嘅關注同埋回應嘅。咁喺婦女團體咧就覺得呢個係一個好好嘅進展，是可以保障到婦女的安全和權益。但另外一方面呢，是記者朋友和其他的人權組織呢有很擔心言論自由和就新聞自由呢是會受到限制。所以呢就在這麼多大家的關注底下，我們希望呢今天這個研討會就可以請到不同的專家或者是持份者，都是大家最上一堂咁樣傾下咧，究竟咧喺保障同埋自由之間咧，是否能夠取得平衡咁樣？咁樣今日咧好高興咧，我哋有唔同嘅講者咧係可得喺我哋嘅當中嘅。咁咧就或者讓我咧先介紹下幾位講者先。咁咧就包括咗咧係或者由我嘅最右手邊開始先啦嚇。咁咧就係國際特赦組織香港分會的Mabel 歐美寶理事的。咁咧喺阿 Mabel 隔離嘅咧就係Professor John Biggenshaw， 佢係香港大學社會科學院嘅副主任副院長，咁亦都係咧前香港法律改革委員會私隱問題嘅成員。咁有Professor John is the Dean is a associate， 我翻譯咗唔該嚇。咁咧非常之好啊，因為今日咧我哋都有一個即時傳譯嘅設施嘅嚇，咁就幫到我嚇。咁啊，啲英文唔係咁好嘅人，咁咧就逢係即係所有大家係講廣東話嘅時候咧，咁我哋咧喺即時嘅傳譯咧就翻譯俾 Professor John。咁而咧就當我哋係講廣東話嘅時候咧，即時傳譯咧，咁同時咧就係翻俾 Professor John 聽嘅嚇。唔該曬大家。咁咧就Professor John 隔離咧有香港記者協會新聞自由小組嘅召集人盧曼斯女士。咁喺盧曼斯隔離嘅咧就係黃瑞雄大律師。咁咧就喺我最右手邊咧，就係我哋香港婦女中心協會嘅總幹事廖佩珊女士。咁咧今日各位講者咧就會有就住唔同佢哋嘅範疇咧，就會發表一啲嘅意見咁樣。咁咧就希望帶嚟咧我哋更加多嘅一啲 insight。咁咧喺開始之前咧，都做少少即係代表我哋嘅大會咧，係表達對幾位講者嘅一種嘅感謝同埋尊重嘅。咁咧，我哋就製作咗少少嘅紀念品，咁咧就或者咧攞一份上嚟，我哋介紹一下先。係啦，呢個紀念品咧就係其實我哋一位義務嘅藝術家嚇，咁就方朗賢小姐嚇，阿 Vanel， 咁佢咧就做咗呢個作品，咁咧就其實佢嗰個意思咧係代表咧係家庭咧可以有好多選擇，一個黑色同埋一個白色。咁黑色咧係代表咧，如果佢係比較陰暗嘅話咧，就會演繹為咧暴力係有危險嘅象徵嚇。如果咧佢係能夠平衡到家庭入邊各方嘅需要嘅時候咧，就會咧創出一個咧就係晴朗嘅天空啊。So we have two bottles already. Okay, that's good 嚇。咁咧就所以我都想咧就請Mabel 嚇幫我哋咧就拋兩個嘅紀念品啦。俾我哋兩位嘅講者嘉賓嘅， 該係 Professor John。Professor John, please。係，唔該啊，盧思敏女士。好，唔該曬 ，Mabel 啊。咁咧，跟住咧，請香港婦女中心協會總幹事廖佩珊女士啊，代表我哋咧就接送少少嘅紀念品啊。俾阿黃信同戴律師嘅，好多謝各位。咁咧就麻煩阿兩位留步先。咁咧就我哋想做一個大合照啊。咁咧就好麻煩幾位講者咧就一齊出嚟有一個大合照嚇。It's a memory.
So you think that's very important? Yeah.
就請各位講者就坐，即係辛苦大家要即係移動啊，不停嘅移動咁樣啊。咁咧就接下落嚟咧，我就想先請咧就Professor John 咧就先咧就就住依一個法律改革委員會嘅立法建議咧係作講話先嘅，請 Professor John。咁咧我哋就有一個即係報時嘅系統喺度嚇，咁就仲有五分鐘嘅時候，我哋有同事咧會遞一遞嘅牌俾各位嘅講者嘅。咁各位嘅聽眾咧，其實你哋可以有耳機嘅話咧，就只要開著個耳機，咁就會有一個紅燈咧就指示嘅嚇，咁咧就調校嘅聲浪咧就會聽得到嗰個翻譯噶啦。咁如果有問題咧，就請舉手，工作人員咧會埋嚟幫你嘅。嚇，試一試先。試一試先嚇，翻譯可以講少少嘢咁樣，睇佢哋聽唔聽到歌。有冇問題啊？個耳機聽唔聽到啊？聽到係咪啊？好，好，好，唔該，將時間交俾Professor John。
Okay, I apologize that my Cantonese is not good enough to present. So I hope you can follow with the benefit of the simultaneous translation. I'm very happy to see so many people here today. My history of interest with stalking goes back a long time. It is now more years than I care to remember since we started looking at privacy issues in the Law Reform Commission. It goes back to 1990, and the stalking report is already, I think, approaching 10 years. So it's taken a long time to get the government to take these proposals seriously. So the starting point in the Law Reform Commission consultation was to talk about what do we actually mean by stalking? How do we define it? So it was defined as behavior which subjects someone else to consistent conduct, which could be either active or passive, which over a period of time amounts to harassment. And in the legislation, it specifically talks about at least a certain number of times. So this is a very broad problem, and it's very hard to, I think, give very specific definitions, because it can depend very much on the circumstances. If I know that you are scared of spiders, and I come and put spiders on your desk, you probably would be pretty scared. For somebody who doesn't care about spiders, maybe they just smash the spider with a book, and they don't take it seriously. So we all have our own issues, I think, things that we are scared of. What you're scared of may not be the same as what I'm scared of. And often with harassment, often with stalking, there is some connection between the people. Either I know you, or I think I know you. I mean, there are people who stalk people who don't really know them. But in many situations, there has been some prior connection. So, one of the key questions we were asked originally was, what is the evidence that stalking is a serious problem in Hong Kong? I think the honest truth is there isn't much in the way of good research to quantify how serious a problem it is. However, if you look in the media, you will find many good examples. If you look at cases that come to court, you will find many good examples. And during the original Law Reform Commission consultation, there were many people who came forward and submitted stories to us which are quite frightening. So I think to anybody who heard those stories, you would not doubt that there is a problem that needs to be addressed. I went and did a check of what the current research was in terms elsewhere as to how serious the problem stalking was. At the time of the original Law Reform Commission consultation, the only good data was from the US. And as the report is often quoted, is that 1% of women and 0.4% of men reported that within the last 12 months they had been stalked, of which around half of them had reported it to the police. Since that time, there is now a lot more information about how serious the problem is. So I went and did my research this week. There's a very detailed report in Sweden. In a Swedish report, 4% of women and 1.6% of men said they had been stalked within 12 months. And in Sweden, around a third of them reported it. And interestingly, of those who did report it to the police, about half of them thought it helped to report it to the police. Now, the UK study, the women part is consistent. It says 4% of women. I'm rather surprised that this report said it was actually 6% of men within the last 12 months. And again, about a third of them had reported it to the police. So I think at least there clearly are differences in different cultures. I think there are differences perhaps in how often stalking occurs. There may be also differences in people's perception as to what is stalking in different situations. Now, I'm not going to talk about the legal protections because you have a barrister who's much more qualified than me to talk about that. But I think what I would argue is that none of the current civil or criminal remedies are sufficient. That's not to say that more could not be done with the existing laws. It may well be that even more could be done with the domestic violence ordinance that has been done. But in most of these situations, it requires certain conditions. So for example, domestic violence, although it has been broadened, still requires a cohabitation at some point. So if it's somebody who's never cohabited with you, then it's not likely you can use that ordinance to protect you. And I think the key element is the difficulty in getting police action as things stand now. So what have other jurisdictions done? Well, many jurisdictions now do have stalking laws. Canada, the US, Australia, England and Wales, New Zealand. Last year, Scotland was added to the list. It amuses me that the government document talks about the UK. In fact, Scotland is very different legally from England and Wales. They have quite different legal provisions, but they have recently, within the last 12 months, no, sorry, just over 12 months ago, I think, so recently, within the last 2 years, they have introduced legislation in Scotland, which is quite different from the England, the legislation in England and Wales. The US has a modern code, course of conduct, reasonable fear of injury, while the California style requires that there is a credible threat. So it's not the same in different jurisdictions. England and Wales, which is the legislation which the Hong Kong legislation was primarily based on, they now have nearly 15 years of experience. It says a course of conduct he ought to know alarms or causes distress, and he ought to know causes fear of violence. It has restraining orders, it has a civil remedy. There were 300 convictions in the first year. There are now many thousands of convictions. And I think in Hong Kong, the primary issue was the fear of journalists. The UK experience, I would say, is that has not been a problem. I'm not saying it necessarily means there will be no problem here, but at least the UK experience, I think, provides some reassurance. Now, what about the proposal that Law Reform Commission made? It said a course of conduct which you ought to know amounts to harassment. That's a criminal offence. Harassment serious enough to cause alarm and distress. So not just simply waving to you every day on the bus. Ought to know if a reasonable person in possession of the same information would think so. That's what I meant. There may well be context. If I know that you're scared of a spider, putting spiders close to everywhere where you're going to go can cause you alarm or distress, even though it might not put another person in alarm or distress. But if I know that you're scared of spiders, then that clearly would be harassment. There was no higher level offence for fear of violence because we felt once you get to the point of where there's clear physical violence, there's other legislation that can be used to provide protection. The defences were prevention or detection of crime, lawful authority, and a critical one, as far as the media were concerned, was reasonable under the particular circumstances. And we pointed out there should be specific account taken of three of the articles in the Bill of Rights. So that's privacy, family, home, and correspondence, freedom of expression, and peaceful assembly. However, the government proposals, one of the interesting things is that they do not consider this necessary. Their argument is the Bill of Rights underpins the whole legislation, so there's no need to make special reference to it. The penalties we proposed were up to 2 years, fine and imprisonment of up to 2 years, if you knew that it should have caused alarm or distress, 1 year if you ought to have known. So that's a weaker sense there. There's a possibility of restraining order. We did propose to require counselling, evaluation or treatment. The government has actually rejected this part on the grounds that the mental health ordinance already provides sufficient protection. And there's also civil liability, so damages and a possible injunction. There were three primary concerns raised during the consultation period. The first was that the hurdle was too low. It was too easy to be guilty. The second one was that we could just rely on the common law. We didn't need specific legislation. And the third one was that the journalists wanted reporters to be excluded. In the final version of the proposal, the hurdle was raised. The issue of common law development is that there isn't much in the way of common law development anywhere in the world now, because almost everywhere else already has a legislation. So once you have legislation, there's no opportunity for the Commonwealth to develop. The concern of the media. At that particular time, you may remember, there was an issue of a judge who was being stalked. So this became a very sensitive issue. I would argue that it is still not reasonable to exclude reporters. The one thing I would say, perhaps there is one element which I have changed my position from the time of the original Law Reform Commission report. In the report, it says that leaving the offence broadly defined, not being very specific as to how many times and how serious it is, was intentional to ensure that the courts could judge the full circumstances. And as far as judges are concerned, I still trust that they would interpret the legislation in a reasonable way. The one thing where I perhaps do have some more concern now is the police. Because I think if you look at what's happened with police behaviour in the last couple of years, it's not clear to me that we can necessarily trust the police to have such an open-minded approach towards this as the courts will have. And as you have to go through the police before you get to the courts, I'm not sure I have quite the same views as I did then. So what's happened since the proposals? Well, there's a lot more experience elsewhere. There's a lot of cases decided in the UK. As I said, there's not much more in the way of common law development. Hong Kong, the domestic violence ordinance has been extended, but that really only addresses cohabitation. Last issue, what's new in the government proposals? First of all, they haven't done any analysis of the experience elsewhere. Secondly, they propose we consider collective harassment. So harassment through a group. I think that's probably a very bad idea based on UK experience. We may not like what the League of Social Democrats do, but I'm not sure we necessarily want to get into an argument with them as to whether they're committing a stalking offence. The penalty, the government's proposed not to distinguish based on whether it's knowingly or not. The question as to whether we should exempt news gathering is still there. As I said, they've proposed to drop reference to the Bill of Rights. They've asked the question whether the duration of any order must be specified, because we suggest it should be open-ended. They've dropped the exemption for law enforcement through a certificate, which I think is a good idea. And they've argued we don't need to have mental health assessment built in because the mental health ordinance already covers that. Okay? So that, I think, hopefully takes you through the broad situation of what the proposals originally were and what's being proposed to change. Thank you.
我哋一陣間都會有即係提問嘅時間啊，咁咧就跟住落嚟咧，我想請呢一個香港婦女中心協會總幹事廖佩珊女士咧，就同我哋分享一下婦女團體嘅觀點。
咁喺呢一度其實都有一啲即係國際嘅，即係我哋所謂國際嘅標準可以睇到嘅嚇。咁譬如話係即係聯合國佢嘅消除對婦女嘅暴力行為宣言入邊啦。咁佢喺嗰度就對於即係婦女嘅暴力有一啲咁嘅定義嘅嚇。咁有啲巧口啊，因為其實本身個原文係英文，咁跟住將佢翻譯。咁但我諗個重點啦嚇，個重點就係話，其實首先嗰啲嘅即係有一啲嘅暴力嘅行為，或者唔係一定要係一啲嘅暴力嘅行為。如果係一啲威脅，即係威脅要做一啲嘅即係暴力嘅行為嘅話，即係你即使係冇一啲即係真係暴力去做到出嚟啦，但係嗰種嘅威脅。咁而呢一啲嘅不論係行為或者係威脅，其實係針對住一個婦女。基於佢嘅性別嚇，陣間點解講係基於性別？陣間即係下一個 point 會講。咁基於佢嘅性別去做出呢一啲咁嘅行為嘅話咧，而呢一啲暴力行為嘅即係後果啦，係會令到個婦女佢係會即係造成身體啊、心靈啊或者係性一邊即係嘅傷害嘅話咧，咁呢一啲就係我哋所講嘅即係針對婦女嘅一啲嘅暴力，即係包括性侵犯。咁點解要係針對住婦女嘅一啲嘅暴力咧嚇？咁我諗即係其實我哋而家嘅社會，即係雖然好似好進步咁，但係我諗我哋都好睇到，其實喺個兩性嘅關係上邊，或者即係喺個兩性嘅權力上邊咧，我哋仲係睇到不平等，即係我哋仲係睇到有一啲即係男尊女卑嘅情況。咁而即係呢一啲即係針對住婦女嘅暴力，其實就係一種嘅即係呢一個男尊女卑嚇男女唔平等嘅情況嘅一啲嘅體現，可以透過呢一個嘅暴力嘅本身，或者係即係透過呢一個威脅嘅暴力，係可以將一個女性咧，就係繼續擺喺即係喺一個即係要受制於男性嘅呢一啲嘅地位嗰度。咁所以我哋會睇到佢本身係呢一個男尊女卑，即係男女唔平等嘅現象嘅一啲嘅呈現，同埋佢嘅後果咧，亦都係會繼續即係將呢一個男女嘅唔平等，即係男係對女性嘅歧視咧，係可以去繼續嘅。因為其實如果擔心，即係有好經常係有呢種嘅擔心，即係有呢啲暴力嘅行為嘅話，其實係會障礙住女性佢去即係充分咁去發展佢自己，或者即係障礙住女性係可以咧係去即係享受緊佢一啲嘅即係應該有嘅自由同埋權利。咁例子啦，即係我諗喺我哋即係作為一個婦女團體，我哋今年有31年嘅歷史。咁我哋其實即係做好多嘅服務，譬如話透過我哋嘅熱線啦，每年有即係4000多嘅來電，透過我哋嘅免費法律諮詢服務嚇，咁主要係針對住家事法啊，或者一啲即係婦女面對暴力嚇嘅家暴啊呢啲咁嘅法例，咁我哋每年有即係200多婦女啦，去即係接受呢個服務，咁仲有我哋個案嘅服務。咁我哋睇到即係當然我哋呢度冇一啲好長，即係我哋自己會，我哋冇做即係針對住即係所謂 stalking 呢個前面，我哋做一啲嘅統計。咁但係我諗喺我哋即係平時我哋嘅即係服務嘅經驗裏面，其實都有即係都有一啲嘅例子，即係我哋去睇到。咁我諗可能即係其實大家都會諗到，譬如話受虐嘅婦女，即係一啲家暴嘅受害人。咁譬如可能佢哋喺即係分開咗，即係離開咗屋企嘅期間。譬如佢嘅即係暴力嘅丈夫要去揾佢啦嚇，跟蹤啦嚇，一啲嘅跟蹤啦，一啲嘅電話啦嚇，咁亦都係持續性嘅去揾嘅咁。咁又或者有啲即係甚至乎就已經離咗婚㗎啦嚇，離咗婚咁當然如果有小朋友撫養權俾咗個媽媽嚇，咁但係就即係當佢咁，但係譬如當個撫養權俾咗個媽媽之後，其實個探視權即係個爸爸都依然係有個探視權㗎嘛。咁所以即係變咗呢一個經常即係每一次嘅探視咧，其實就係製造緊一啲嘅機會，俾嗰個即係曾經有暴力前科嘅呢一個嘅爸爸咧嚇，或者嘅前夫咧，就即係有一啲嘅機會去騷擾嚇，去呢一個嘅婦女嚇。咁又或者即係一啲追求嘅個案啦咁。咁我諗我哋都聽過有啲嘅情況就係話去跟住個女仔啦嚇，即係首先表白咁啊被拒絕，咁啊跟住就跟蹤啦嚇，跟佢即係喺佢屋企啦嚇，跟到佢翻工啦，咁跟住又等啦，又追跟到佢翻工翻屋企啦，咁啊途中其實都未必知道嘅本身，咁但係又收到啲信息就話你今日著啲衫好靚啊，咁好襯你啊，你而家去到邊度啦咁樣，即係透過呢啲係俾你。個女仔會知道，我雖然我見唔到呢個人，但係我知道有人喺度跟緊我，即係喺度跟緊我。咁其實嗰種嘅心理上面嘅壓力，嗰種嘅擔心，即係會唔會擔心佢仲有下一步咧？ 你究竟要跟到我幾時？你除了跟我之外，會唔會仲有其他嘢咧？咁我諗呢一啲其實係對於即係個女性嚟講，心靈上面有好多嘅即係嘅障礙嚇。咁其實即係頭先講嘅嗰個情況，警方冇乜嘢可以去做得到嚇。咁直至到即係可能佢真係要去進一步，譬如話可能走出嚟攬住佢夾硬錫佢咁樣樣去強吻。咁即係如果呢個案件就係因為咁樣樣先至即係可以係有啲嘢即係去做嘅啫。咁但係佢當佢唔係做緊一啲即係去侵犯緊佢，即係呢一個所謂即係犯咗刑事係啦嘅一啲嘅罪行嘅話，其實個女仔其實真係冇乜嘢可以做得到。咁又或者我哋嘅個案裏邊，我哋都有見到嘅就係話夫婦啦要分居嚇，咁本身就係個男方就同意個女方就繼續住喺個婚姻居所裏邊，個男方自己搬走。咁當然個即係婚姻居所係個男方名下嘅啦嚇。咁但係跟住之後咧就要即係後來可能又反悔啦，即係諗下諗下又好似唔係好著數咁樣。咁又要翻轉頭每次就可能係幾時幾時要同佢講，我幾時幾時要上嚟攞翻啲嘢。咁攞翻啲嘢咧，跟住就搞到屋企就亂七八糟，抄到亂就咁，跟住就走。咁跟住又可能再隔冇幾耐咧，又要翻上嚟，又抄到啲嘢亂曬俾佢攞嘢，即係藉住係佢攞嘢。咁我諗就住呢啲個案，其實我哋都有即係同我哋啲律師去傾，喂，咁呢個屬於即係家暴咧，家暴條例得唔得啊？即係個而家呢個咁唔得噶嘛，係嘛？家暴條例其實你講緊嗰個暴力，咁呢啲係咪一啲嘅暴力咧？雖然發生喺個家庭裏邊嚇，咁可唔可以攞禁制令叫佢喂唔俾佢嚟呢一度？咁似乎又好似唔行得通，唔得。咁點算咧？即係佢係咪個婦女係咪就係真係好無奈？你幾時要話俾我知你要上嚟？間屋又係你個名嘅喎，係咪啊？咁我就要俾你入嚟，跟住就搞到我啲嘢亂曬。咁呢啲即係經常性嘅，咁呢啲點算咧嚇？我哋其實對個婦女都係一啲嘅好苦惱。咁所以我哋即係見到嘅情況就係話啊，其實而家嘅法例，我哋見到有啲地方其實係真係唔係好可以去幫到。咁唔好意思咧，但係對英文因為比較難，唔想再翻譯。咁其實都想去諗一諗因為其實都就住呢個，我哋去睇翻有啲咩嘅出路咧嚇。咁我哋都有睇到，譬如一啲外國嘅例子，歐盟啦，佢哋喺2001年咁啊做咗第一點嗰個係嗰個報告書嘅嗰個名嚟嘅。咁你見到其實佢主要都係講緊一啲即係譬如話violence against women 啦，對婦女嘅暴力啦。對小童即係細路仔啊，或者係即係關基於一啲即係性傾向嘅一啲嘅暴力啊，咁佢喺裏邊咧，佢就將stalking 即係將呢個纏抱咧係擺埋落，即係當為即係嗰個對婦女嘅暴力嘅一種嚟嘅。咁佢喺首先喺嗰度佢就做咗一個所謂嘅 stalking， 即係睇翻佢自己所有嘅喺歐盟嘅成員裏邊。有幾多係有用立法，即係佢哋嘅法例裏邊係點樣去處理緊？頭先即係呢度講個主題啊，即係呢三種，即係針對呢三種唔同人士嘅一啲嘅暴力嘅行為，佢哋個法律係點樣樣寫嘅？咁就住呢一個纏繞嘅嗰部分咧，佢就睇到喺成員國27個成員國裏邊咧，有12個係已經係即係立咗法嚇，去即係個別嘅法例咧係去處理呢一個嘅纏繞嘅呢一個嘅行為。咁我呢度下面就即係直接將佢即係報告裏邊即係200多頁咁樣，咁就抽咗一啲部分，即係我覺得相關想同大家分享一下。咁譬如就話啦，佢哋會覺得即係如果有一個即係獨立嘅條例去處理即係呢個前一啲嘅即係所謂暴力嘅話咧，其實係可以係等大家咧去更加認識得到啊呢一啲即係個別嘅情況，呢一啲其實係對於一啲人權嘅一啲嘅確認，或者即係嗰個暴力本身其實係侵犯緊人權，即係呢個講緊，所以佢其實講緊嘅就係話對於嗰個我哋嘅意識嚇，覺得即係對於呢件嗰、那個即係譬如話纏繞嘅話，原來係一個即係侵犯緊人權嘅一啲嘅行為嘅話咧，佢覺得呢個係一個即係有咗一啲公眾教育嘅呢一個嘅目的嘅。咁另外咧，亦都有講啦，就係話法律本身啦係一個。即係好好嘅一個即係公共教育嘅一個嘅即係工具嚟嘅，咁所以佢哋都話覺得即係你如果獨立咁樣立咗法，第一樣就係話可以去即係提升嗰個嘅意識，對於權利嗰個嘅爭取， 第二就係亦都係即係法律本身亦都係一個好好嘅一個教育嘅工具，話俾人知咩可以做，咩唔可以做啦。某一啲嘅潛在行為咧，即係潛在嘅行為咧，你就做好唔好做啦。咁仲有啦，佢亦都有講話有一啲嘅即係暴力嘅行為咧，其實就係即係需要一啲即係特別嘅即係方法要去處理嘅。咁佢呢一度咧就舉咗例啦，佢就話即係纏繞呢一個佢哋喺歐盟嗰度，佢哋睇到咧就係話證實咗，佢哋覺得啦，證實咗係一個如果係一個如果是一個即係擺咗落去一個可能普通的刑法裏邊咧，其實是冇咁有效去即係阻止到呢啲纏繞行為嘅出現，而反而將佢獨立去立法嘅話咧，其實佢覺得係有助去即係去幫手即係去制止到呢啲嘅問題出現。咁另外佢亦都最後屘就講啦，就佢都去拉翻嘅，佢就話佢覺得咧佢會建議即係成員國裏邊咧就係有一啲即係普遍。我哋大家即係作為一個歐盟嘅成員國，都要去遵守或者即係都要去做嘅一啲即係最基本嘅一個嘅準則嘅。咁佢其中一個準則咧就係話，佢覺得呢一個嘅纏繞咧係應該即係需要係將佢去刑事化嘅，去保護到即係婦女啦嚇，免受到即係佢哋嘅即係人權啊、自由啊呢啲去侵害。咁我諗即係係啦，擔心一定有啦嚇。咁尤其是裏邊佢講緊一啲嘅集體嘅騷擾嚇。咁我諗我哋作為一個婦女團體，亦都即係我哋唔係只限於去提供一啲嘅服務去做，即係俾啲婦女。其實我哋都好睇到，譬如話婦女嘅處境點樣要去改變，除咗係即係好個人咁樣去做之外，其實好多時候都係因為即係基於一啲嘅政府嘅政策、法律或者一啲嘅即係資源嘅分配嚇，呢啲公共嘅資源分配。所以我哋都即係好主張咧，就係話我哋係要透過發聲向政府去表達意見，表達婦女嘅聲音訴求。所以我哋都做好多嘅即係集體嘅行動嚇，咁去表達嘅咁。咁所以我哋擔心，即係我哋呢啲嘅集體嘅行動，例如我哋坐咗喺禮賓府出邊一段即係長嘅時間，咁呢啲會唔會第時就變成一個集體嘅騷擾咧嚇？咁我諗呢啲即係如果係嘅話咧，我哋就即係絕對係好擔心嚇。咁另外即係我諗陣間Miss 都會講多少少，即係新聞嘅自由，即係對於記者嘅工作。咁我諗就講翻即係另外一個角度，即係我嘅婦女其實都係一個人嚟嘅啫嘛。人係即係有好多嘅權利，即係所謂嘅人權嚇，包括譬如話我哋免受暴力對待嘅權利，我哋嘅一啲嘅人身自由，我哋一啲表達嘅自由係啦。咁仲有一啲嘅就係我哋嘅即係希望係可以去獲得一啲即係對於公共利益涉及公共利益嘅事件嘅一啲嘅知情權。咁呢啲亦都要好靠記者朋友。他們是一個有利的環境可以去做到即他們的工作，我想這些也都是一些憂慮。那怎麼辦呢？即有什麼方法呢？我估我們可以提一些即我們的一些想法，但是不是一個最好的方法，我想也都有待會繼續去討論。那有些方法就是說，可不可以將現在的家暴條例只是民事的，可不可以將它加入一些刑事的部分。但是我們又覺得家暴條例，我想正如剛才Professor Professor Chong 也說過，譬如說你沒有同居過的，即除了即不是結婚的話，沒有同居過就不適用的嘛。對於譬如我剛才舉的例子，追求者怎麼辦呢？不落的。還有就是其實現在政府去做事，要去改一條法例不知要多少年，家暴條例剛剛才改完沒多久，又要他再改，究竟他有多大的意願去做呢？咁呢個纏繞嘅呢一個即係將佢刑事化，其實佢而家都叫做擺咗一個即係嘅諮詢文件啦，希望可以快少少啦。咁所以我哋就覺得咁樣去稱，即係係咪又要即係如果佢出攞家暴條例，拱佢去改家暴條例嘅話，會唔會亦都需要等一個好長嘅時間嚇？咁對於即係而家每日面對緊纏繞嘅即係嘅情況嘅呢啲婦女，其實即係對佢哋講，亦都係咪公平？咁或者我們會不會即係我哋淨係攞咗一啲即係可能要限制佢呢個纏繞嘅行為，淨係針對住一啲即係譬如話對婦女嘅暴力啊嚇呢啲嘅即係部分嘅記者嘅嗰部分，我哋先唔好處理住先嚇，即係其他嗰啲唔相關嘅嚇，我哋唔好去即係唔好去處理住先，淨係講咗即係婦女面對緊暴力嘅呢一個部分。咁另外其實公眾教育都真係好緊要，即係我諗唔單止淨係俾警方，即係唔單止俾警方，我諗公眾教育都好緊要。即係譬如家暴都需要係一 啲好長嘅時間，亦都透過好多宗嘅慘劇，最後先至等即係警方係可以去有一個醒覺，佢覺得即係家暴其實唔係一啲嘅即係家事，係即係需要即係警方去介入去處理。咁如果一啲纏繞嘅行為，其實都希好希望喺即係推法例嘅同時，亦都有一啲即係教育嘅部分，或者即係警方亦都有一啲即係相關嘅指引，係要去知道點樣去知道，即係呢一個面婦女面對緊呢個纏繞，其實亦都唔係一啲嘅小事，唔係一啲個人與個人之間嘅一啲嘅糾紛㗎。咁我諗呢，即係大致上即係係啦，講咁多，咁亦都留翻啲時間，陣間大家可以多謝大家。
好，啊唔該曬啊，時時嚇。咁啊，即係婦女，即係係好多好多需要嘅嚇。咁咧就好似有一個立法嘅機會，但又好似好多矛盾。究竟呢一個嘢，即係對我哋係好定係唔好嘅咧嚇？咁喺法律上邊有冇啲乜嘢嘅即係保障咧？嘅現有嘅漏洞有一邊咧？咁有冇出路咧？咁接住落嚟咧，就想請阿黃瑞雄大律師咧，同我哋就香港現行法律上對婦女嘅保障咧，係發表佢意見。
喂，聽到啦？就我諗我時間所限啦，咁我比較簡單同埋集中，即係我想講嘅嗰個焦點喺邊？咁其實就今日咧，我諗我哋都未必可以話係可以好，即係一個研討會嘅形式，就未必可以好仔細去睇某啲嘅問題。咁但係我希望我可以做到一樣嘢，就係點出一啲相關嘅議題，等大家去思考同埋之後再去討論嘅。咁其實就住纏繞行為嗰部分咧，喺而家政府嘅建議度咧，其實我就睇到有幾方面嘅問題咧，係即係值得大家去諗嘅。第一咧就係其實佢喺而家嗰個即係我講緊值得大家去諗咧，就當然我哋考慮，即係話嗰個基礎就係一方面可能婦女團體或者一啲人權團體，我哋希望纏繞行為係一啲我哋可以接受嘅嘢，所以我哋希望有個立法，然之後將佢變咗做刑事化嘅時候咧，係可以即係個社會係確認嚇，我哋係唔接受呢啲咁嘅行為。咁希望透過立法，透過將佢刑事化咧，係帶出呢一個信息。咁但係當然另一方面就係話，我哋都擔心。如果用而家政府所建議嘅嗰個條例嘅寫法嘅時候，會唔會對於記者嘅採訪新聞嘅自由，或者對於我哋一般人去行使我哋嘅憲法權利、嚟集會啊、示威啊、遊行嘅自由咧，係會造成一啲我哋嘅不必要嘅限制，甚至係打壓咧？咁我就係從呢一個角度去睇而家政府提出嚟嘅嗰個條例草案，有邊啲地方係值得我哋去留意，或者係可以點樣去諗法嘅？咁第一樣我頭先即係都有講啦，其實喺嗰個纏繞嘅定義嗰度咧，都係值得大家去諗，因為似乎呢個就大家都冇話好多焦點擺落去睇，但係其實咧都係可以進一步去研究，因為而家政府個定義咧就係、是、簡單啲嚟講，佢就係講緊話，即係如果一個人做出一連串嘅行為，而嗰啲行為咧係會令到嗰、那個即係我哋所謂嘅受害人啦嚇，佢會覺得驚恐或者困擾嘅話咧，咁其實呢個就係構成嗰、那個纏繞嘅行為啦咁。咁其實本身纏繞或者話我叫騷擾啦，做出一啲騷擾嘅行為，令到一個人覺得驚恐或者困擾咁樣。咁其實本身騷擾呢一個字咧，就喺即係我哋法律方面好多嘅案例嗰啲，其實都有一啲嘅界定㗎啦。咁反而呢一個字係比較闊嘅，即係騷擾呢一個。咁如果當假設啦嚇，當呢個條例通過咗，用呢一個定義去咗法庭嘅話咧，咁法庭反而會睇得比較多咧，就係、是、之後嗰、那個就話令到嗰個人覺得驚恐或者困擾。咁呢一度咧就係、可以斟酌嘅，即係如果你問我，我就覺得你要將纏繞行為去界定嘅，咁你無可避免可能都係用騷擾啊，或者呢啲咁樣嘅字眼，或者重複用翻纏繞咁樣嘅字眼嘅。咁但係究竟係騷擾嘅行為去到乜嘢地步，而係需要變咗一個犯法嘅行為咧？咁其實就係跟住佢個定義入邊所講嘅一連串嘅行為啦，令到嗰個人覺得驚恐或困擾，嗰、那個就會係個關鍵。咁究竟係咪用驚恐或者困擾，定係其他嘅一啲嘅字眼？呢度咧就可以斟酌。點解我咁講咧？就係、因為其實喺而家好多一啲嘅遊行示威嘅活動入邊啦， 然之後出現了一些問題，跟住警察會拉，然之後會控告咧。而家其實佢當時都會用一個就叫公眾地方擾亂秩序嘅行為去告佢哋嘅。咁而喺公眾地方擾亂秩序行為嗰個擾亂秩序咧，就其實係一個好普遍嘅一個法律定義，用得好多。而喺世界各地，包括香港咧，對於擾亂秩序嗰樣嘢咧，其實都有一個好即係比較清楚嘅界定。而嗰個清楚界定咧，亦都係考慮翻咧，就係話當我哋行使公民權利嘅時候，點為之過咗火位，去咗做擾亂秩序。咁喺嗰度咧，喺界定擾亂秩序嗰部分咧，其實都會牽涉到頭先講嘅，令到一啲嘅受眾咧係覺得困擾啊、驚恐啊，一啲類似咁樣嘅字眼嘅。咁所以嗰部分咧，我哋係可以攞嚟借鏡，因為無論係歐洲人權法院、歐洲人權法院或者歐洲人權委員會，或者係一啲聯合國即係一啲普通法嘅國家，例如紐西蘭啊、英國啊，佢哋已經有相當多嘅案例咧，就住一啲行使言論自由，即係憲法權利嘅一啲嘅活動，而入邊出現咗一啲係所謂違法嘅嘢，例如擾亂秩序，佢去做出個高界定。咁所以其實呢部分咧，如果我哋喺纏繞或者我哋叫騷擾啊嗰個定義入邊，我哋可以去考慮呢啲嘅案例，再仔細啲，即係佢哋好仔細咁去分析，然之後我哋揾翻一啲嘅定義嘅字眼。咁嘅時候咧，嗰啲嘅字眼咧，其實喺即係全世界好多國家或者係歐洲人權法院或者係委員會，佢哋已經講咗去到咁，你先至可以去到話係犯法嚇嗰、那個遊行或者言行行使你個憲法權利嗰啲行為咧，係去咗犯法嘅位啦，已經去到係擾亂秩序嘅位咁樣嘅時候咧。如果你參考嗰啲嘅話咧，咁再用喺而家我哋去界定騷擾嘅時候咧，其實已經可以係一個保障到，即係其中一樣嘢啦嚇，可以去相對保障翻咧。當我哋去睇乜嘢叫纏繞行為嘅時候咧，係唔會過咗嗰條線，即係將佢個定義定得太闊。變咗咧，當你有啲行使言論自由啊、集會自由嘅時候咧，那個限制咧係唔合理地被呢一條前條法咧係限制咗。咁所以呢個係大家可以嚟緊有時間咧可以去研究嘅一樣嘢。咁第二部分咧，第二樣嘢咧就係、是、我其實我係順住個次序，就唔係代表個重要性。其實最重要係反而係我而家嚟緊講嘅嗰兩樣嘢就比較重要。但我就順住次序講啦嚇。第二樣嘢咧就係、是、其實喺政府嘅建議入邊咧，就佢提出呢個叫集體騷擾嘅行為嘅。咁其實佢分開兩部分，雖然佢係用一個字眼，但其實佢分開兩部分。佢集體騷擾嗰部分咧，其實佢連埋之後講嘅，即係話一名嘅纏繞者去騷擾多名嘅受害人，其實係一眼兩面嘅講法啦。因為講緊嘅集體騷擾嘅行為咧，就係講緊一班人去騷擾一個人，咁另外一個咧就係一個人去騷擾一班人，咁其實我就將佢籠統呢個叫做集體騷擾行為。咁呢一個咧就真係好大問題啦，而我都睇唔到，如果佢針對即係婦女團體，我哋成日都關注嘅嗰啲個案嘅時候咧，我睇唔到呢一個嘅需要性。咁政府喺自己建議入邊咧，佢將呢一個嘅需要性咧就擺喺追債嗰啲嘅行為，咁佢就因為好多時追債咧，都係一班人上去個門，上去一個人屋企咁，跟住就追債咁。咁如果你係只係單對單嘅前咗行為咧，你針對唔到呢啲行為。咁佢又有嘗試去解釋㗎，雖然現行法例咧其實係有嘅，現行法例咧我哋有一個嘅原則咧就叫做共同行事嘅法律原則嚇。咁佢就但係呢個都唔足夠啊。咁其實咧，因為我啱啱打緊一單案。都係啲人就會示威自由講，而我哋就係喺度拗緊呢個共同行事嘅呢個原則，即係拗到七彩，係絕對包容嘅。因為喺嗰個案件入邊，政府就係用共同行事呢個原則咧去控告嗰啲被告。咁所以咧，其實如果要針對收數嘅嗰啲問題去處理纏繞嘅行為咧，共同行事嗰個原則咧係絕對包容。如果共同行事嘅原則都包唔到嘅話咧，其實嗰啲行為就唔應該當佢係犯法嘅啦。其實簡單啲嚟講。咁所以咧，要解決政府一講緊話收數嗰個問題咧，其實係唔需要用到佢呢個集體騷擾嘅嗰個定義咧去包嘅。 咁倒翻轉咧，另外嗰、那個即係話一名纏繞者去騷擾多名受害人嗰、那個咧，其實就得英國人做咗呢一個做法嘅啫。英國就開宗明義啦，佢過呢條條例咧，就係、是、去針對一啲愛護動物團體，去一啲嘅服裝公司賣條草嗰啲啦，最大家聽得最多嘅嚇、去作出抗議啊。其實佢針對嗰啲行為，咁其實呢一條條例就好明顯係真係打壓遊行示威言論自由噶啦。咁環保就喺政府個建議入邊咧，佢都講香港暫時冇呢啲問題，亦都唔見到有人會覺得呢啲行為係離譜到需要去立法去規管。咁所以如果呢一部分即係話講緊集體騷擾行為呢一部分咧，如果係完全可以剔除嘅話咧，咁其實喺影響言論自由啊或者係新聞採訪自由嗰邊咧，其實又會多一部分嘅保障啦。咁呢個就係我第二樣嘢要提出嘅，即係大家可以去關注。就係、是、直情係唔應該立法去規管呢啲集體騷擾行為，唔需要。咁第三樣咧，就係、是、另一個都好緊要嘅範圍咧，就係講緊免責辯護嗰部分。咁免責辯護嗰部分咧，其實成個部分咧都好大問題嘅。個問題就係喺一開頭將一啲我哋覺得可能合理嘅一啲行為，即使係即係點講咧？我哋覺得纏繞行為，但我哋唔希望將纏繞行為刑事化咗之後咧，包咗一啲我哋唔應該想包嘅行為。咁而家政府嘅做法就係將呢一紮嘅行為咧擺咗喺免責條款度。咁但其實喺刑事化方面咧，將一啲行為擺咗喺免責條款嗰、那個問題係啲乜咧？嗰、那個就喺原則上係好大問題嘅。個問題就係在於咧，喺嗰個法律程序上面咧，法律原則度咧。如果你將一些行為放在免責我們叫辯護理由免責那邊的、那個範圍裡面的時候呢，就代表呢首先控告那方控方即是檢控那邊他是不需要去證明那個案件裡面沒有這些行為，所以這班人不應該告他，不需要去證明他沒有了這個責任。他只因為在我們香港法律裡面就是說一個罪行有很多個元素 ABCDE，咁檢控嘅責任咧，佢就要去證明咧 A、B、C、D、E 都存在喺呢個案件入邊，佢先至可以提出去起訴嘅。佢有一個表面證據去證明 A、B、C、D、E 存在，咁佢就可以去告。又或者倒翻轉咧，如果嗰條條例寫明咧要有 A、B、C、D、E， 然之後咧唔可以有 F， 唔可以有 F， 咁嘅時候咧個檢控咧佢就要去證明咧喺呢個案件入邊有 A、B、C、D、E 同埋冇 F。大家明唔明白嗎？所以呢，如果我們將沒有 F 這個元素不是放在個控罪元素裡面，而將它丟在辯護理由免責那邊的時候呢，作為警察作為檢控呢，它不需要證明呢在這個案件裡面是沒有這些元素。簡單來說，就是說你記者採訪這樣，如果我們將記者採訪或者恰當的，我們不要說任何啦，恰當的合理的嘅一啲記者採訪活動，我如果你將呢個活動擺咗喺個法罪行元素入邊，作為係一個豁免咗嘅一個因素嘅話咧，咁控方就要證明喺而家我告嘅呢個入邊咧，佢係唔牽涉一啲恰當嘅採訪活動。如果個案件係有恰當嘅採訪活動嘅時候咧，佢唔告得，點查唔拉得。又或者，但係倒翻轉啦，如果你將恰當嘅採訪活動咧擺咗喺免責條款，即係辯護理由嗰邊咧，咁喺警察拉人、控方告人嘅時候咧，佢唔需要考慮呢啲嘢，佢唔需要考慮你而家所牽涉嘅嗰個罪行係咪有恰當嘅採訪活動嘅。佢總之就係話你中咗 A、B、C、D、E， 我就拉你，我就告你。之後你作為被告，你去到法庭，你話喂，我有個辯護理由，我有個免責條款，就係、是、我呢個係恰當嘅採訪活動，呢、這、一個責任去咗被告嗰度。被告要在法庭上去證明自己所做的事是一個恰當的採訪活動，那整個責任就不同了，那個責任就去了被告那裡，而那個的責任的準則呢是相對可能性，即是51%和 49% 的比例，你證明到51%，但如果你將這個恰當的採訪活動變了那個法例的元素是豁免了出去的話，那控方就要去證明這個案件裡面呢是毫無合理疑點，即是 100% 呢是沒有牽涉恰當的採訪活動，那個責任就在警察那裡，就在檢控那裡。 咁變咗點樣將呢一個恰當嘅採訪活動嚟我哋而家最關注嘅呢一樣嘢，點樣擺法咧？其實就好影響到最終呢條條例係咪可以平衡到，即係簡單啲，可能就係婦女團體或者係一啲媒體兩邊嘅考慮啦。咁所以呢部分係好即係好關鍵。如果呢一度可以將嚟我哋而家諗到嘅一啲我哋關注嘅嘢，唔希望呢個纏繞法針對嘅嗰啲行為，如果我哋係有幾樣嘢係我哋關注嘅時候，如果我哋將佢擺咗喺辯護嗰邊咧，即係免責條款咧，就出唔到個效果。其實或者出嚟嘅效果其實爭好遠。倒翻轉，如果我將佢擺咗係喺嗰個罪行元素入邊，講到明呢啲咁樣嘅行為咧係豁免咗出去嘅，咁咧。整個保障咧就會大咗，個平衡咧就會做得好啲。咁政府嗰、那個建入邊咧，佢有講嘅，佢話咁如果要將成個記者新聞採訪活動都豁免咗，咁好似唔係好合理喎，因為可能有啲採訪活動真係離曬譜咁樣。咁其實佢就有啲取巧嘅，因為佢就係話將記者採訪活動、記者採訪的活動咁樣嚇豁免咗出去，但其實。你豁免啲乜嘢嘢嗰個可以斟酌噶嘛？你可以加好簡單一個恰當嘅記者採訪活動咯，或者一個合理嘅記者嘅採訪活動咯。咁因為其實佢將呢個記者採訪活動呢一樣嘢咧，佢話其實喺而家嘅免責條裏面已經包咧，佢又唔係寫話記者採訪活動，佢就話咧恰當嘅記者採訪活動咧已經包咗喺嗰個免責條款入面啦咁。但係到佢講豁免嘅時候咧，佢就唔係講緊恰當嘅記者採訪活動咧豁免咗。咁所以其實要回應翻政府嘅講法咧，其實就係可以有一個建議，即係我初步諗，可能大家去做研究，就係話直接將一個我哋將佢定義為一個恰當或者一個合理嘅記者採訪活動，係直接豁免咗出嚟嚇。咁其實就已經可以達到即係政府嗰個講法，即係我初步諗到。咁如果大家可能諗緊仲有其他一啲嘅活動，例如言論自由咧嗰啲嘢，我哋都覺得應該要豁免嘅時候，咁可能大家可以去討論，然之後睇下用一啲乜嘢嘅時間。是可以去寫，然之後將可能豁免咗出去。其實呢個就係最一了百了或者相對即係好清晰啲嘅寫法。咁去到最後尾就係、是其他建議，其他即係個建議入邊嘅其他啲部分，例如個罰則啊，或者出禁制令拘捕令。其實我覺得嗰部分就唔係太大問題啊。你點樣發又好，或者禁制令拘捕令嗰啲，其實喺現行嘅法例啊、法律嗰邊，其實都幾清楚咁樣寫，咁就唔係啲咁大問題嘅地方。反而就係我頭先所點出嘅嗰三部分嚇，即係話免責條款啦、集體騷擾嘅行為啦，同埋對於騷擾個定義咧，呢三樣嘢咧係可以去斟酌。咁最後我好快因為我都知道有一啲嘅團體都會關注啊，會唔會纏繞法嗰度會包埋一啲可能我哋去遊行示威嘅嗰啲活動咧？咁其實我相信，如果我哋將集體騷擾行為撇除咗，我哋將正當嘅新聞採訪活動擺咗喺豁免嘅，我哋唔係叫免責條款，擺咗喺豁免嘅嗰個犯罪元素邊咧？其實會中到咧，即係會捉到呢啲人示威活動嗰個機會咧，其實就會低好多。同埋咧，始終香港確實咧，我哋去到最後尾咧，我哋有一個安全網，嗰個安全網咧就係喺而家個法例入邊咧，就係、是、人權法講得好清楚嘅。你任何一條法例同基本法同國際人權公約呢啲係相違背嘅話咧，嗰條法例本身已經係違憲，法庭唔會執行嘅。所以有呢一個最基本嘅，咁當然啦，我哋而家個考慮好多時都唔係去到法庭，而係喺警察拘捕嗰個位啦。咁但係我相信，即係如果我哋作出相應嘅頭先嘅嗰啲嘅調節嘅話咧，應該都會有一定程度嘅保障或者幫助。咁我講咁多，多謝你。
唔該曬 Linda， 咁就好似即係有啲曙光喎，係咪咧？咁樣，咁咧就有待大家陣間再去傾下，咁跟住落嚟咧就想請即係香港記者協會新聞自由小組主席林小姐咧，就講下即係喺記者組織嘅方面咧對呢一個嘅諮詢文件嘅睇法啊。
多謝曬大家，咁咧就介紹下我自己先啦，咁 我的正職是一周刊的調查報導做記者嚟嘅。我以前咧亦都喺報紙嗰度做過，咁就喺明報啦，同埋信報都做過。咁啊，當我仲做緊報紙嘅時候咧，咁我嘅專責咧就係一啲弱勢社群，即係社會福利啦，同埋勞工嘅新聞。咁喺當我仲做報紙嘅時候咧，其實我都接觸咗唔少嘅弱勢社群嘅團體，咁亦都知道咗咧佢哋即係亦都報導過好多關於即係佢哋俾人纏繞嘅問題。或者他們住在一個很隱蔽的家庭中心，目的就是因為真的很害怕這樣。咁就算我哋新聞界入邊咧，有啲女主播啦，生得好靚嗰啲咧，咁成日都俾人哋纏繞啦，咁啊得閒又收到很多禮物啊，又或者放工又俾人跟啊嗰啲咁樣。咁所以咧纏繞呢個問題咧，其實我都理解即係弱勢社群嗰個苦況，同埋佢哋面對嗰個心理困擾係點樣。咁但係咧，當我哋去討論即係你哋有咁嘅困擾嘅時候，係咪代表就一定要有立法呢一樣嘢咧？咁今日咧就係想引發大家即係思考得深入啲，就係第一係咪真係有必要去另立一條法例先至可以達到保障嗰個目的咧？第二咧就係個法例條文啊，而家出現咗有一啲問題，有啲咩問題引致到咧嚇我哋記者業界咧對呢一樣嘢係有好多嘅憂慮喺度咧咁樣。咁我今日嘅講咧主要就係圍繞呢兩樣嘢，希望可以大家一齊去諗得深入啲。咁咧先討論講翻少少背景先咧，就係其實咧法律改革委員會咧喺回歸之後嘅1998年咧都曾經提出過咧就係對纏繞法立法嘅建議。咁當時咧即係記協啦同埋幾個新聞團體咧都表達咗一個好強烈嘅保留意見。咁到而家即係14年之後啦回歸曾蔭權喺落台之前咧佢又再次咧就出咗呢一個嘅諮詢文件出嚟啦。咁咧，當我哋再細閱翻呢一個諮詢文件咧，佢嗰個將纏繞行為嗰個定義咧，除咗頭先黃律師有講嗰個之外咧，咁我而家仲讀幾句俾大家聽，咁大家留心聽住呢幾句咯喎，就係話咧喺唔受歡迎嘅情況之下咧，登門造訪啦，發出他人不容收到嘅短信啦，嘅通訊啦，注視或者暗中監察受害人嘅居所或者工作地點。向第三者披露受害人私隱等等的行為都叫做纏繞。嗱，講完呢個之後我必須要話俾大家聽我哋記者的工作是做啲咩嘢？嗱，記者如果我哋最崇高的一個理念就是監察權貴啦，揭露社會的一啲唔公義的事件啦。咁最近如果大家有看新聞的話都知道非常精彩啊，日日都爆不同的嘢出嚟。第一單就是報紙揭發了行政長官候選人唐英年咧屋企有僭建，大家都看到啦嚇，佢喺九龍藥道的屋企門口就連日嚟都吸引了無數的記者咧就喺度採訪，咁仲租埋嗰啲吊臂車添啊，好似機械人嗰啲咁樣就租了很多很多架喺佢門口。但係根據頭先我讀嗰個定義，就係話，如果第日立法之後，會唔會當我哋再發現唐英年屋企有僭建，我哋再租吊臂車去採訪嘅時候，就會俾佢話你呢班人全部喺度搞緊我哋，纏繞我哋，纏繞我，唔該你哋，我而家要引用呢一個法例去停止阻止你哋啦。咁會唔會有呢個情況發生咧？嗱，呢個就係我哋要諗嘅問題啦。好啦，第二個例子，我哋嘅特首。最近被人拍到跟一些富商游船河坐私人飛機，甚至乎他在深圳間屋都是富商幫他租的。好了，跟住我們去採訪了，我們可能要租一隻船，可能要在離遠的大海那裡去找個長鏡去釣去拍他照片，或者我們要去深圳他家屋那裡門口那裡扮係買家啦嚇，睇下上去究竟阿特首嗰個豪宅有幾豪華啦。我哋可能要喺佢深圳樓下嗰度等啦，甚至乎唔單止係深圳喎，佢日日去教堂喎，我哋要問清楚佢，佢要解釋俾我哋聽點解你作為一個特首會做呢啲嘢咧咁樣。好啦，第日呢一條法例出現咗之後，又係根據我頭先所讀嘅定義，會唔會當我哋喺監察呢啲高官同埋富商嘅利益嘅時候？他們會引用這條法例去阻止我們的工作呢？ 嗱，呢一樣嘢咧，又係大家即係我哋亦都會去思考嘅一樣嘢，因為法例咧，往往都會被權貴係用咗嚟到去做一啲達到你自己嘅目的嘅嘢。咁再舉一個例子咧，就係、是、啊，即係我自己啦嚇、啊，我幾個禮拜之前咧，我都做過一個新聞，就係、是、懷疑呢一間電信商咧，同一啲江湖勢力有啊，懷疑黑社會嘅江湖勢力人士就勾結。咁我自己咧都要上去咧嚇嗰啲收數公司嗰度拍門啦、啊，又或者係即係去可能係要跟下佢哋一啲嘢啊啲咁嘅樣。咁我目的唔係話我哋要搞佢或者係跟蹤，而係往往係透過我哋去跟佢哋一啲路線而發而睇到哦，原來呢一個電信公司同埋呢一個黑社會勢力嘅人係有一啲咁樣嘅嘢存在嘅等等。咁、那個過程我自己都好驚嘅喎，咁但係個問題就係唔代表我哋唔應該做呢樣嘢，因為我哋個信念就係我哋要揭發一啲唔公平嘅嘢，所以我哋就更加要做呢一樣嘢。咁好啦，講到呢度，你可能會話：，嘿，你班記者講咩啊？成日都有人投訴你哋嘅，成日話你哋派狗仔隊嚇、啊、去搞啲明星，去跟啊邊個劉德華，一跟到譚詠麟嗰啲咁樣，啲演藝名人就最中意話你哋㗎啦，咁樣樣。其實我們都聽到這些聲音，因為演藝人協會那裡都有這些這樣的講法出現了、在立法會的時候他們都表達了他們的看法，但是呢我必須要講一件事呢，就是第一我們問過這個私隱專員公署，在這麼多年來他們都沒有收過任何的投訴，就是說娛樂記者或者記者去纏繞任何人的投訴，在這麼多年來是一單投訴都沒有收過，這個第一。第二就是如果娛樂界名人真的覺得記者要纏繞他們的話，為什麼他們不去投訴呢？還是這個是他們和娛樂記者合作見報的一個模式呢？第三呢就是香港的狗仔隊有多嚴重，會比起外國是怎樣呢？這一件事是不是有一些實際的統計數字可以講到出來呢？咁當我哋對狗仔隊有個指控嘅時候咧，我覺得我哋一定要係講翻清楚成個 picture 係點解點樣樣先得。咁好啦，講到呢度咧，咁或者咧我都再講下，好啦，翻去婦女團體嗰個需要嗰度啦，就係、是、究竟而家嚇即係纏繞啦，大家都講咗一啲例子出嚟，即係幾咁嚴重。咁但係，其實社會的迫切性是有多大呢？或者可不可以提供到一些數據是證明到現在的立法是必須要立刻去做呢？保安局呢，我們看一些資料，就是保安局局長李少光在去年的6月22日在立法會上曾經表明過，一些追債和非刑事資料的舉報在2006年至2010年之間是有所下降的。咁喺去年嘅頭五個月咧，有關嘅舉報咧，更加係比前年嘅同期咧，就係、是、下降咗兩成。至於呢兩年嘅罰則咧，係明顯對唔住係下降咗咁樣樣。罰則咧亦都係高咗咁樣樣。咁政府咧，如果佢要話俾我哋聽呢一條法例係必須要立嘅時候，係唔係要講翻俾我哋聽，究竟呢一個纏繞嘅問題，特別係婦女纏繞嘅問題有幾嚴重？但係政府咧喺呢一刻咧都講唔到一個實際嘅畫面出嚟。咁頭先咧就思慈都有提到即係歐盟嗰個立法嘅情況啦。咁睇到咧，只係有大概一半嘅國家咧就係就呢一樣嘢係進行咗立法。但是其實很多國家他們對於纏繞法是否真的可以做到一個保障，還是打擊一些人權和言論表達自由這件事都有一些隱憂在這裡。用這個英國的例子，或者我再講多一點點，怎樣呢？這個法例是有一些前科，就是打擊了記者採訪的活動。在2007年有攝影記者咧，同埋採訪社運佢採訪一啲社運人士啊，去一個英國嘅能源公司咧，叫做 Empower 做一啲抗議活動嘅時候咧，咁嗰個公司嘅示威者咧，公司啊就用示威者嘅行為咧滋擾咗佢哋嘅廠房員工為理由，咁就透過當地嗰個纏繞法啦，佢哋叫做免受騷擾嘅法例咧，就係申請咗禁制令。咁咧，連記者拍攝示威嘅行動咧，都係被禁制，即係佢唔單止禁制社運人士，亦都禁制咗咧係記者嗰個拍攝。 所以咧當地嘅傳媒咧就爭取咗即係三個月先至可以獲得豁免咁樣啦。咁雖然咧即係喺今次嗰個採訪文件就話啊，如果你第日誒俾人拉咗啊，你記者你可以咧即刻提出啊，我哋係用緊一個合理行為做一個辯護啦咁樣。但係咧個問題就係、是。他一拉你嗰下咧，你已經因為捲入咗一個訴訟咧，而你係唔可以繼續你嘅採訪工作。換言之咧，當我要調查僭建咧，我又要即刻要被迫停咗，而呢個調查嘅活動咧就唔可以再做落去。所以對於傳媒嗰個監察權貴同埋社會嗰個工作咧，係有好大嘅影響喺呢一度。咁亦都係頭先講開英國啦，嗱佢喺1997年咧係訂立咗呢個叫做面授騷擾嘅法例。咁咧喺引用嘅宗數咧，其實係比當日咧當局估計嘅200多宗為多嘅，即係2002年嗰個引用嘅宗數咧係去到6000宗咁多嘅。咁點解會咁多人去引用咧？咁呢樣嘢咧就即係大家即係要再做多啲去討論，因為咧當中頭先我講嗰、那個係唔係一種濫用新聞自由採訪嘅一個例子咧咁樣？咁呢一樣嘢大家亦都要諗。咁係啦，講咗咁耐啦。咁喺記協嘅立場係點樣咧？咁你頭先開始又話你都理解到婦女團體嗰個問題喎。咁其實咧，我哋認為咧，其實咧喺現行嘅一啲法例入邊咧，只要擴大或者係修例，將譬如家庭暴力條例啦、放債人條例啦，或者係人身傷害條例等等呢一啲條例入邊咧，只要加入防止纏繞嘅條文，或者將呢個纏繞刑事法咧，就可以保障到咧係受害人嗰個利益。咁有啲人就會問我哋啊，點解你不如你接受呢一條法例立法啦？咁至多咧就新聞採訪嗰度可以豁免咗出去咁樣。咁但係咧，我哋會擔心嘅咧，就係因為法例入邊咧嗰個界定實在係太闊。頭先你聽到其他講者都有提到，係市民嗰個表達自由咧 ，overall 咧係會受到一啲損害。所以咧，我哋情願係唔要呢條法例，而要咧就係喺現行嘅法例加入一啲保障嘅條款咧，就已經足夠。因為其實我哋記者協會除了關注我哋自己嗰個新聞採訪工作之外，我哋都係關注緊民間嗰個表達自由嘅訴求。如果日後咧嚇，即係網民可能喺網上面改圖啊，持續咁樣喺度改圖，或者持續發表啲言論批評權貴嘅問題，會唔會都已經構成纏繞咧？甚至乎真係有 action 有行動去示威嘅時候，又會唔會係都有一個？問題出現咗喺度咧，又或者你哋參與社會事務，去政府總部嗰度示威要求政府立例保障一啲社會婦女權益嘅時候，會唔會都會係變成咗一面雙面人咧？即係呢一個法例，咁大家都要認真去考慮嘅一樣嘢。咁總括嚟講咧，就係我哋嘅立場就係認為冇需要立法啦。在現行的法例裏面可以作出一些修訂，就保障到弱勢社群的權益啦。亦都希望呢民間可以，因為個原因就是我們希望民間可以保障他們發聲的權利，不希望這一條條例又在一個這麼闊的界定裏面會成為了呢就是一些扼殺言論自由的工具。多謝大家，或者我們稍後可以再討論。
接下來就請國際特赦組織香港分會總幹事歐美寶小姐係發言嘅。
雖然係喺個角落頭同埋係最尾嗰個發言，咁大家唔使咁擔心，因為咧我會好簡短。咁其實咧首先要同大家交代翻咧國際特赦組織咧喺呢一個法例上邊咧，我哋仲有一個確實的立場嘅，咁最主要咧就因為我哋係一個國際團體啦，咁喺好多時喺法例上面嘅立場咧，我哋必須要做一個仔細嘅研究，然後咧就喺嗰、那個用一個法例上面嘅角度啦引用翻一啲嘅國際嘅公約咧，去睇翻究竟呢一條法例係咪應該立咧？立的時候是應該去落實的。不過我也希望可以跟大家 講翻一啲我哋如果係要考慮嘅時候，係用一啲乜嘢嘅國際嘅原則或者準則咁樣。咁好簡單，因為其實咧，我諗我就唔就住成個法例，咁而係一啲喺呢個法例裏邊咧係已經出現咗嘅一啲嘅大家好關心、好關注嘅討論點咁。譬如話這個法例是很針對關於婦女的安全、婦女的福祉的。其實呢，因為國際特赦組織香港分會呢在家暴條例修例的時候呢，其實我們都在那個大聯盟裡面的，其實呢都有一起參與家暴條例的修例。其實呢這個問題剛才時事都已經說了，即有很多的例子呢已經說了，其實在家庭暴力裡面呢有很多的婦女和小朋友，他們也是面對一個很嚴峻的問題，就是一個或者前夫啊，或者前的伴侶啊，不斷的騷擾。所以在這個問題上面，我們也很理解那個要立法的，或者是要在那個家庭暴力條例裡面或者在那個法例上面的要求的迫切性。咁我哋亦都係根據我哋國際特赦組織裏面對於要防止同埋係打擊呢個婦女暴力呢個問題上面咧，其實我哋係有一個亦都有一個標準同埋立場喺度嘅。咁其實但係我哋大部分嘅喺要打擊婦女暴力呢個問題上面咧，很多時候的討論和那個政策立場呢就是去了一些的人生的暴力問題上面，即譬如說是強姦啊、非禮啊這一種但對於譬如說纏繞啊這些這樣問題是完全不關注呢，但是也不是，因為我們裡面呢講到這個一些外來的勢力或者是一些壓力呢被迫令到婦女去要譬如說跟延續一個關係，一個性關係啊，或者是如果我們講話強姦也都是因為一個性暴力的問題啦。咁如果我們講話這些嘅暴力的行為呢，其實不是只是講人身安全這一樣嘢。咁其實，譬如話，對於心理上面嘅一啲嘅，造成心理嘅壓力同埋恐懼啦，呢一種咧，亦都會係我哋關注嘅暴力範圍裏面。咁所以咧，纏繞呢個問題咧，其實都會喺我哋關注嘅範圍裏面，但係咧，我哋未有一個好清晰嘅法律政策文件咧，可以支持我哋話我哋其實都好贊成。要立這個纏繞法啊，咁樣咁其實嗰、那個立場就喺香港，尤其是而家呢一刻咧係未清晰嘅咁。咁但係咧頭先阿時時其實提出嗰啲嘅歐盟嘅標準咧，或者歐盟已經立咗法咧，咁其實對我哋嚟講係一個好大嘅參考嚟嘅。咁我諗尤其是阿 Linda 咧講到仲要參考翻歐盟這些條例裏面它怎樣去定義一些什麼行為是為之前的這一方面呢，其實我覺得我們是需要做到的功夫。因為最主要呢就是雖然說歐盟的國家裏面呢都有很多的國家是已經立了這些法例，但是呢也都同時呢就是說它其他的法例是否完全都是一樣呢，或者他的執行的時候呢那個政策呢是否都可以是配合的。因為其實我想最主要呢就是比較回譬如說他已經有一個纏繞法例，但是相對於我們在這條法例裡面的討論呢譬如說對於言論自由啊這一些這樣的處境呢，那些的國家是否都有相應的法例或者一些政策是走出來呢，是以防止到政府是會用這個纏繞法去打擊言論自由這個問題呢，那我想我們是真的需要去研究的。那好像剛才 Mason 也提到這件事，那我就覺得 如果我哋講話即係言論自由呢個問題啦，咁其實亦都係一個即係國際人權組織好核心關注嘅問題嚟嘅。咁我哋已經50年嘅歷史啦，咁所以喺好多嘅國家裏邊咧，其實我哋都有一啲即係對於點樣建立翻保障言論自由呢一樣嘢咧嘅法例嘅即係嘅倡議嘅工作上面咧，其實都有一定嘅經驗。咁其實我哋最高嘅標準咧都冇他嘅，好多時咧都係跟翻一啲國際嘅標準。咁我哋最主要咧都係會睇翻即係公民和政治權利公約裏邊嘅標準啦。咁對於言論自由啊咁樣樣啦，咁佢裏邊咧其實咧除咗話講言論自由之外咧，亦都同時咧亦都會提到我哋個人嘅一啲私人嘅自由嘅。譬如話第17条，咁佢已經講咗話任何人嘅私生活、家庭、住宅同埋通訊不得無理或非法侵擾其名譽同埋信用，亦不得非法咁樣破壞。第二咧就係對於呢一啲嘅侵擾同埋破壞，人人有受法律保護嘅權利。咁呢個咧就係講我哋嘅私人嘅權利嘅。咁其實咧香港咧係有私人法例。咁頭先阿 Miss 有講過，即係私人專員啊，佢哋裏邊嘅工作啊。咁我亦都想睇下，哇！其實我哋有私人條例啦，咁究竟佢得唔得咧？咁頭先你提到嗰啲即係演藝人咧，就冇去投訴。咁但係我哋其實咧就曾經咧，即係唔係國際人權組織，係我以前嘅工作嘅單位啦。新婦女協進會咧，其實係曾經係接過一個個案嘅，就唔係演藝人，係陳巧文。當陣時咧係一周刊，咁樣咧就一周刊咧就係採訪，咁跟住咧就係好遠，佢哋話好遠咁樣影到佢，但係咧其實係好清楚，佢喺屋企裏邊，咁而係咧就係佢只係著住應該係內衣褲啊咁樣，咁而係俾人影到。咁跟住咧，我哋就亦都即係佢向我哋求助啦。咁我哋亦都去諮詢即係私隱條例上面係咪可以幫到佢啦。咁結果係幫唔到佢嘅。咁而因為嗰個原因咧，我哋亦都有同記協去溝通。咁就係話我哋亦都有俾信俾記協，就問咁呢個問題可以點樣解決？咁我哋其實就係投訴一周刊啦。咁而我哋個回應我哋嘅咧就係話嗰個係唔構成侵犯私隱嘅，因為咧佢其實明知佢屋企嘅窗咁大，佢唔應該喺佢個窗嗰度即係走嚟走去咁樣咁容易俾人影到。咁但係當時房主陳雅文咧，佢講嘅咧就係其實佢屋企對出咧係冇嘢嘅，即係唔係有啲咩大，即係唔係有其他嘅，因為佢住村屋。咁唔係有其他嘅村屋咧，係咁容易可以見到佢呢樣嘢。咁所以咧，當陣時咧，我哋就有一啲嘅即係往往嘅即係有投訴啦，咁亦都有回應嘅咁。咁所以，但係咧係唔滿足到我哋覺得呢個案主係疏忽，或者呢個案主係自責難犯。其實佢真係俾人侵犯私隱，咁但係我哋係冇辦法。咁所以咧，其實頭先我哋討論到嗰個重點咧，喺呢一個嘅法例裏邊，其實我哋都係睇緊，即係除咗係一啲講緊話即係家暴上面嘅問題啦，咁亦都有係提翻一啲我哋過往係處理唔到嘅，即係佢唔係唔認識啲記者嘅，咁所以譬如話陳巧文佢係處理唔到呢個問題，咁但係咧。講到話處理唔到呢，即係呢個私隱嘅條例處理唔到呢個問題嘅時候，咁我哋又睇翻，咁究竟呢、這個即係而家政府推出嚟，即係呢一個嘅前條法，咁又處理即係可唔可以處理到咧？咁但係頭先幾個講者咧都已經講咗啦，即係佢個定義咧就係一連串嘅行動，咁一連串嘅唔係行動，一連串嘅行為係令到佢覺得即係嗰個事主係覺得好唔夠忍受啊。不受歡迎啊咁，如果我哋舉翻陳巧文呢個例子嘅時候咧，佢唔會係一連串嘅，佢可能影一張就夠嘅咯。咁如果佢影一張就夠嘅話咧，咁我哋又未必可以用到呢個法例咧去處理佢呢個問題喎。咁所以我諗咧，其實我哋跟住落嚟嗰個討論嘅關鍵咧，就係呢樣嘢，即係話頭先我哋提到嗰啲其他國家已經有嘅例子。
我哋用一啲咩嘅角度去睇翻嗰啲例子啱唔啱我哋用？又或者係呢一條法例，我哋又對比翻嗱，佢政府就同我哋講啦，話啊，我而家為咗你呢個問題咧，我俾條法例你處理呢個問題啦。咁究竟我哋即係攞住佢呢條法例，係咪真係處理曬我哋嘅問題咧？同時，如果佢係處理咗我哋嘅問題嘅時候，我哋亦都有一個公民責任去睇翻佢呢條法例有冇造成其他嘅問題咧？咁我諗亦都要即係我哋講我哋即係保護婦女嚟講咧，咁其實都係人權嘅其中一個好大部分。咁我哋唔可以淨係睇自己嘅權利㗎，咁亦都係廣泛睇翻一個人權嘅角度。咁如果呢一個法例佢推出嚟係除咗好似即係搭救其他嘅嘢俾你咁，即係可能你買魚腩咁啊，搭翻其他啲嘢俾你啊咁樣。但係嗰樣嘢咧，其實咧係唔好食嘅。咁我哋要唔要咧？即係咪全成條條例完全係冇傾過？即係完全係唔係冇傾啊？完全係冇經過其他嘅篩選去我哋，我哋就要你啦。咁我哋就要呢條條例啦。咁我哋就要咗佢先啦咁樣。咁我諗咧，呢個已經好重要，因為咧對於而家呢個時刻咧，其實我哋真係見到即係政府對於鉛制即係言論自由啊、錯綜自由啊上面咧係有好多嘅動作嘅。咁如果即係新聞工作者或者係我哋要行使我哋嘅憲法權利去做一啲示威遊行嘅行動嘅時候，係因為有呢一個法例去鉛制咗嘅時候咧。其實對於我哋再去爭取婦女嘅平等同埋或者係一啲婦女嘅福祉嘅時候咧，亦都係會加上咗好多嘅枷鎖嘅。咁但係我諗我都係即係重新講翻句啦，我哋對於呢個法例咧就仍然未有一個話究竟係咪贊成啊，或者係定係反對嘅立場。不過我諗今日咧，我亦都好想聽下大家嘅意見。咁我講到呢度。
位多謝分享，咁嚟緊都係時間咧，就俾台下嘅朋友講講先嚇。咁因為在座有唔同嘅團體啦，亦都係有唔同嘅組婦女組織啦，同埋一啲婦女喺度。咁咧就想大家即係自由嘅可以發表你嘅問題或者你嘅意見。咁就請講之前咧，講講你係咩名啦，同埋咩單位嘅。
It's not really a question, it's... I just wanted to make one point first. My concern is that we recognize that we do not have comprehensive privacy protections in Hong Kong. We have personal data protection orders. So for Maisie to say, well, people aren't complaining to the Privacy Commissioner, the Privacy Commission can only help if the issue relates to personal data protection. It cannot help for other privacy issues. So the government is doing a consultation on stalking, but there are other reports which they still have sitting in their drawer to address other privacy issues which they haven't yet brought forward and which I think are essential if we want to have comprehensive privacy protection. So there is in particular one proposal to have two privacy talks, one of which would address intrusion, one of which would address public disclosure of private facts. There is also another pair of proposals on interception and surveillance. The government was forced to implement a part of those proposals that deal with law enforcement, because otherwise the courts would not allow them to do surveillance or interception. But the protections against long-lens photographs, for example, taken unreasonably, don't exist. And it's because the government has ignored the proposals again for 10 years.
Kita,
可以發言啊、發問啊，或者係再追問清楚啲嘢。
我係姓董嘅，咁係另外一間家庭危機中心嘅同事嚟嘅。咁我其實就想問Professor John 同埋黃律師嘅，因為我知道咧改會嗰個報告咧都有檢討翻現行法例文字同埋形式個不足嘅地方啦，就係、是、需要一個新嘅法例咁樣。咁但係頭先幾嘅朋友就話咧可以改善依家個法例去保障一個。即係去 anti stalking 嗰個 behaviour 嘅，咁就想問下嗰位社長啊，黃律師咧，即係咪真係即係唔可以即係修改依家個法例，而需要一個新法例
？Sorry, I didn't quite follow translation. Can we use the existing law without having a new law? I think the answer is that can address part of the problem, but not all of it. I think the, so again, if there is an existing or a prior domestic relationship, then arguably by further elaborating on domestic violence orders, if it's about money lenders, then again, arguably you can address it through that orders.But the reality is there is a significant number of stalking cases where neither of those pieces of legislation could apply. Again, during the consultation of the original proposal, there were some terrible stories where people were being harassed by somebody. They had no idea why that person was harassing them. As far as they knew, they had no prior relationship with that person. And it got so bad, those people left Hong Kong because they could not escape.Those people who were stalking them, and the police showed no interest at all in giving them any help because there was no physical violence involved.
其實就喺法改會嗰份文件度咧，其實佢都有審視翻而家嘅香港嘅民事法同刑事法，係有冇啲咩相關嘅法例其實。可以處理到我哋諗到嘅嗰啲纏繞嘅行為嘅，咁其實法改會嗰個都係幾全面嘅一個審視同埋討論。香港冇錯嚟，可能好簡單，我哋有啲咩叫有當罪啊？頭先講啊，公眾地方擾亂秩序啊，有大家冇聽過嘅咩撥打或傳送一啲令人厭惡嘅段。電話或信息啊，有呢條法例，或者係寄送一啲違禁嘅物品啊咁，咁跟住有啲打交啊、言字恐嚇啊咁，咁即係每一代都會有啲可能可以處理到部分嘅，有一啲嘅纏繞行為。咁但係確實咧，就係話依然都會有啲嘅纏繞行為咧，係冇一條法例係可以針對到。咁其實反而最可能大部分的前因行為，我哋所講可能即係話一個前度的人或者男朋友、女朋友咩都好，佢需要一些前度的男女朋友嗰啲。咁好簡單，而家香港主要的就是家暴條例啦，因為你都是講緊呢啲騷擾啊、恐嚇啊嗰啲咁行為。咁但係家暴條例即使修改咗之後，都涵蓋咗好多嘅關係都好，都是建基於一個家庭關係，又或者是建基於同一屋檐下同居的關係。咁變咗我哋。知道好多嚟啲前度啊，或者前妻，即係呢啲其實可能前妻而家包啦，但係前度男女朋友嗰啲其實已經唔包噶啦。咁但係嗰啲其實都即係我理解，我知道前嘅都有唔少呢啲咁嘅案例啦。咁另外啲就其實冇關係嘅喎，可能係一個即係暗戀嘅對象咁，咁嗰啲係完全冇關係，咁其實你都未必包得到。咁而另外即係話應該咁講，所以而家嘅法例面咧，散收收有一啲處理都有啲處理。而另外一個問題咧，除咗係散收收之外咧，就係話喺而家嘅法例入邊咧，你會話有一啲嘅法例係處理得到咧，其實係某程度上將嗰啲法例咧係有啲扭曲，去夾硬去處理原本定嗰條條例嘅時候咧，唔係諗住要處理嘅嗰啲行為嘅。咁嗰個唔好嘅地方係咩？其實我舉一個例子，大家就會好明白。偷拍影群底那些，其 其實香港而家冇一條法例係去處理影群體嘅問題，但係枕住都會有人俾人拉啊成咁。咁點解咧？就因為政府又冇諗住立法，咁啊喺而家個法例度咧就諗住揾一啲嘅法例去處理。咁於是乎咧就係而家用得最多就係話公共地方擾亂秩序，同埋一個叫做有違公德。有違公德係一個普通法，唔係一條法例，成百幾年歷史㗎啦。佢嘅源頭就係有啲醉酒佬喺隨街小便嘅時候咧，就百幾年前就俾人拉有違公德，咁所以有條有違公德嘅罪。咁講翻偷拍嗰個就係話，嚟而家冇一條咁嘅法例。咁政府夾硬用嚟用擾亂公眾地方擾亂秩序咁樣，而家用好大部分用呢條條例去告。咁但係就搞緊係咩咧？就係話喺法庭入邊嘅一啲嘅判詞咧，佢為咗要告得入呢啲影群底嘅案件，佢就將公眾地方擾亂秩序嗰個定義咧就扭曲，扭曲到一個位咧，其實佢將佢無限擴大。當佢無限擴大之後咧，到你有一啲真係相關嘅案件啦，例如我呢排幫手好多嘅一啲集會人員、集會遊行嘅嗰啲案件啦。咁法庭佢哋又係俾人告公眾地方擾亂秩序，咁然之後法庭就去參考嗰啲嘅案例，咁啊死火啦！因為喺嗰啲案例入邊咧，佢將呢條條例扭曲啊，扭曲同埋加闊咗，佢將佢因為香港係行普通法，法院最對一啲罪行嘅定義咧係會影響低級法院或者其他法院。咁變咗咧，你將一啲法例原本都唔係諗住愛嚟打擊嗰啲罪行嘅時候，但係政府又唔立法，咁個法庭就將佢夾硬扭曲，為咗佢無限擴大，去冚埋嗰啲嘅法例，冚埋嗰啲嘅罪行。咁最終影響咩咧？就係話到真正有一啲嘅行為嘅時候，根本其實嗰條法律都唔係諗住打佢嘅，但係因為法院喺判例嘅時候已經將佢擴闊咗或扭曲咗咧，就連帶呢啲其實根本唔應該入咗嗰個罪行入邊嗰啲嘅行為咧，都入埋。咁所以呢個係即係如果我從一個法律嘅角度咧，我係好唔贊成咧，就係夾硬將一啲嘅法例去扭曲，或者去將佢擴大，然之後去涵蓋一啲嘅而家睇到一啲嘅社會嘅問題。咁所以如果即係我覺得一個正確嘅觀念或者正確做法就係真係如果我睇到一啲嘅社會問題嘅時候，我哋應該去就住嗰啲嘅問題去立一個法。咁但係當然我哋要平衡各方面嘅利益或者考慮時，我哋就只不過應該係好努力咁樣喺嗰條法例度應該點樣寫。點樣去確保我哋唔希望影響到嘅嗰啲行為咧，係唔會受到嗰條法例咧去限制？咁我覺得呢個喺而家嘅法例面咧係絕對做得到，因為有啲好複雜嘅罪行，我哋都有法例去監管嘅時候，我唔相信係做唔到咯。咁只不過就係話我哋有冇擺心機落去點樣去寫好一條法例，令到佢係恰當地去處理嗰啲問題。
Jessica。
想問下黃律師嘅，好啊好啊，唔該嚇。Jessica， 嗰啲補充啊，你係來自邊個會？唔該曬。
防止虐待兒童會。
大家都是交朋友的形式啊。
我諗歐盟嗰度或者可以有咩事一陣間都可以回應下。關於嗰部分咧，你提出嗰、那個咧，其實如果我喺條，如果我哋喺條法例入邊寫到明咧，係某一啲嘅行為係豁免咗，即係如果我哋法例，我哋法律嘅用語就叫 exempt， 淨豁免咗嘅話咧，即係成條條例唔適用喺嗰啲情況。咁其實就已經係等同咗你講嗰個意思嘅啦。因為你直情係話唔適用喺嗰啲情況嘅時候咧，即係話咧呢條條例唔係針對嗰啲行為。我想跟住再留翻。
他們是一個真正的民主國家，他們的憲法是可以保護到他們的新聞自由，真的落實得到保障。但香港走到現在這一步，即是回歸十五年，我們的新聞自由的去到立法會捍衛新聞自由的條例會被人否決，我們新聞自由在香港的排名不斷地下跌，我們的政府在發布資訊方面不斷地扣減，即係個現實就係咁樣啊！即係雖然我哋有基本法保障，但係基本法之下，我哋成個社會即係不斷係咁收集、不斷收集嘅時候，我哋真係好有好擔心，我哋嘅政府之後會做啲乜嘢嘢咧？再咁樣，所以我哋寧願唔要住啊！即係喺我哋嘅立場方面，至於剛才黃律師說的那個恰當新聞豁免那樣東西，其實我也想問一下，即那個恰當是怎樣界定的，即什麼叫恰當呢？這樣用吊臂可能都是不恰當，我覺得你是不是，即這件事好像很闊這樣，但是提出這個我剛才都 想了一陣 是對的，即是我們可以再討論多一點，可以有再多一些意見去交流，我也會將大家的意見今天帶回我業界那裡去。
Perhaps I can just comment a little bit on the issue of what problems there have been in the EU. I think as far as the UK is concerned is where there have been the most problems. And I think the problems mainly, as I understand it, relate to the two additional things that the UK has added, which the government has now added into the proposals here. So collective harassment and harassment to deter local activities. I think both of those are very problematic because the core problem we're trying to solve is one-to-one. And I think let's focus on solving the one-to-one problem. As soon as you make it more than one-to-one, then are you dealing with a news organisation against a person, or are you dealing with a person against a company? I think both of those situations are much more problematic. Because I think the UK experience is companies insisted on having that second part of the legislation added in, to try and protect that, as I think Linda said, Peter, but then there are other examples where essentially it's being used to protect companies and government departments and the like. I don't think we want that. We may not support the mini-bombs demonstrators, but I don't think we want to make their demonstrations criminal offences. I think we should be very cautious. I think the one-to-one is the core issue. Actually, I can't accept the journalist's position of saying no law. I can accept they have some fear about how it's actually implemented. And as I said, my primary concern is less with the courts. I do trust the courts will fully defend press freedom. My caution is with the police, because the police are the first line of that process. And I think what we have seen in the last 2 years should make us a little bit cautious. But I think then the difficulty is, if you wanted to have some form of exemption for journalism, we have to be very careful how that's worded. Because the honest truth is, journalists both in Hong Kong and the UK, which is the other key place, have not been reasonable in all circumstances. They have been unreasonable to some people. And it's not just about the rich and famous, I'm sorry. If it was only the rich and famous, I would feel they can usually look after themselves. But it's not. There are numerous cases where the media has harassed people who are private individuals who have nothing to do with public vision. I mean, the example of taking photographs of people. Again, I can never forget a picture taken of a woman running out of a house when her house is on fire, she doesn't have more clothes on. And that picture is, I believe, on numerous magazines, including yours. Right? So you've covered out her face, but you can see which building she's running out of. You can see what clothes that she has on, she's wearing. Do you think that everybody in that street doesn't know who she is? What possible reasonable reason is there from a journalism perspective to have to run that picture? None that I can see of. And we have a culture here where taking photographs of people, injured people on the street in accidents, is acceptable. Why? That has nothing to do with the public's need to know. If you're talking about saying a story that there are accidents, which we need to be concerned about as the public, absolutely. But I think, to some extent, the reason that people feel that we cannot give an exemption to the media is because the media has not been self-disciplined. They have not regulated themselves. I mean, the proposal in Law Reform Commission to have a press council, I now consider a waste of time. I think in UK experience, you can see they did nothing. Even when it was clear that journalists in the UK were hacking people's phones, nobody cared. So the police and the press council were not helpful. So I think we have to be very cautious if we give exemptions to the media. Yes, freedom of expression is very important and we must protect it. But we must also be very careful that we don't give journalists, and I'm not talking about news gathering, legitimate news gathering, yes, definitely we need to protect. But all journalists, I'm sorry, I don't see the argument for that.
好同意頭先阿 John 講，我覺得，因為如果我哋第一就係話，如果已經係將個局限喺針對一對一嘅話咧，其實基本上我哋去遊行啊、示威啊成嗰啲情況會中嘅機會其實好少噶啦，因為當你一個行為講緊係針對一個人對一個人嘅時候咧，同埋你咁可能係一連串嘅行為嘅時候咧，你控方要有足夠嘅證據證明，例如喺嗰五次或者嗰三次嘅行為入邊係呢一個人。去針對嗰一個人，咁變咗嚟，你有啲集體嘅一班人嘅人示威嘅時候咧，控方佢要 spot 到啊，呢個人喺嗰三次嘅遊行集會佢都喺入邊，然之後呢一個人喺嗰三次嘅遊行集會示威入邊咧，佢都做咗一啲嘢係特別針對緊另外嗰個人，而嗰個人係同一個人喎，每一次嘅遊行集會就都係同一個人。咁至於嚟講緊可能係喺即係網上面嗰啲改圖咧，其實我覺得嗰個就好，那個機會會話係講緊。即係纏繞咧，就嗰個定義嗰度咧，其實我哋可以再清晰啲去界定，咁就冇乜機會嗰種情況會係跌入咗而家嗰個定義入邊。咁第二樣嘢咧就係頭先阿 John 講嘅，即係話嗰個豁免嗰個 exemption 嗰個咧，其實嗰部分係緊要咧，就正正針對阿 John 講嘅嗰個警察嗰部分。如果我哋唔將恰當嘅或者我哋叫正當嘅，記者採訪的活動放在豁免，而將它放在辯護的話，就會出現警方執行的時候，因為它不需要去證明那個罪行元素，那它就是否都拘捕了。但倒過來，如果我們將這個恰當或者正當的記者採訪活動，或者是我們叫做它叫做搜集資料啊，即係 news gathering 啊，搜集新聞資料，將佢擺咗喺豁免嘅話咧，咁基本上警方佢就唔可以噶啦，因為你一豁免嘅話，即係呢條條例唔係針對呢啲嘅行為，咁所以你唔可以話拉就拉嚇，你因為你知道本身而家你所針對嗰啲行為就係一啲新聞採訪嘅嘢，咁你唔可以就咁話拉就拉，咁變咗嗰個某程度上咧，其實係局限咗或者限制咗。警方的那個行為，咁但係我亦都同意嘅，即係我個人嚟講，我同意，我唔相信任何嘅記者採訪活動都應該豁免嘅。我哋大家都講緊係一個恰當或者一個正當嘅採訪活動。而頭先阿 Macy 提到，咁嗰個定義係點咧？其實喺法律嘅嗰個範圍入邊咧，對於咩叫恰當，對於咩叫正當嘅定義咧，其實我都相對清楚，即係都有案例啊，有 case 有嗰個討論可以，或者啲判決可以去揾到嘅。咁簡單啲，我依家咁講，即係當然我哋可以嗱有兩種做法，你可以喺個條例度唔作出定義， 你亦都可以，如果大家諗到傾得到嘅，可以喺個條例度對於乜嘢叫合理，叫於乜嘢叫恰當咧，作出定義亦都得。咁但係而家一般我哋所講嘅，例如某啲行為係咪一個恰當或者一個正當嘅行為，如果牽涉係某一個界別嘅時候咧，其實好多時你就會睇翻，例如嗰個行為嘅背後嘅目的啦，佢希望做到啲乜嘢嘢啦。如果是牽涉一個行業的話，就看看那個行業一般的做法，一般社會人士可以接受到的一種做法，那個社會當時那個一般人民接受到的那個準則的程度去到哪裡。所以其實這個定義呢是與時俱進的，即是法庭去詮釋的時候，100年前的準則一定不適合在現在，或者今天一定不適用在50年後的。所以當法庭去理解乜嘢叫恰當、乜嘢叫正當嘅時候咧，其實佢會睇翻當其時社會普遍可以接受到，再加埋嗰個行業一般嘅做法，再加埋嗰個行為喺佢嗰個背景底下幾樣因素去睇嗰個係一個恰當嘅一個行為。咁所以其實即我都可以即時簡單地講到嗰個大概嗰個方向原則嘅時候，其實呢部分嘅討論咧，喺唔同嘅法例咧都有採用呢啲嘅字眼，咁所以法庭要揾嗰個意思咧，其實就唔難。咁但係當然，如果我哋想有再多啲嘅保障嘅，而又處理得到嘅，咁咪喺個法例度寫清楚咯。
我好快講幾句，即係行業大家都好關注我嘅行業咧，有好多即係操守有問題嘅記者咁樣啦。Which 啊，我都知道係有咁樣樣嘅事。但是呢，究竟那個問題有多嚴重呢？即是大家收到的投訴是怎樣呢？即是我想如果真的要細，即是講這個纏繞法去到討論記者操守這件事的時候呢，大家就真的要拿回一些實際的，即是數字也好，或者現象也好，去講這件事。但我今天想講的呢，就是那個新聞自由那一件事，即是那個現在這個政治氣候，這個社會氣候裡面，剛才我講，立法會都可以否決得新聞自由條款的時候，我們還有這條法例，而這條法例背後也都可能是有一些東西界定是咁闊咁清楚的話的時候呢，對我們來說的而且確是有一個憂慮在這裡。我想可以再討論，即如果大家對我們的行業有什麼很不滿還是怎樣，都即是大家可以歡迎打電話來給我們。
咁啊，唔該曬，講誒，坐，我哋有位朋友都有意見嘅。
係，我係香港婦女中心協會主婦聯盟嘅成員婉容。咁我哋嘅婦女咧，好多時都會行出嚟，咁將我哋尤其是家庭主婦嘅需要向政府去發聲嘅。咁喺呢個社會上講纏繞法嘅時間咧，我哋開會，我哋嘅主婦咧都有擔心，當好似頭先各位講嘅講到嘅，當法例如果去規限一遊行示威，就譬如向某一個司長或者政府某些官員遞交請願信啊，或者有一啲對社會政策嘅質詢啊，咁係唔係構成個纏繞率都咧，咁我哋嘅主婦係表示好關注嘅。咁另外有一啲我自己屋企嘅事咧，就想講一講，就係我個家人咧兩年前咧就向財務公司借咗錢，但係已經還清曬。但係兩年幾之後，今個月咧就收到封相關信。就話佢仲未還清啲錢，而且會即係唔會再另行通知，會採取法律行動。咁咧就每日都有電話嚟我屋企。咁直至而家為止咧，咁我屋企人咧就打個電話去俾嗰、那個叫做負責人啦嚇。咁就但係咧就我屋企人係一日打咗三次電話，嗰、那個人接到電話咧，佢都唔出聲。咁跟住咧就冇再有電話嚟啦。但係我頭先出門口嘅時間，我望到個信箱有封信，又俾我屋企人嘅，就係寫住重要文件。 件，咁同呢件事有冇關係咧？我大家都未知道。咁我想請問，如果嗰間財務公司再有類似咁樣嘅行為嘅話，我哋需要係點樣應對咧？
不如好唔好聽埋另外一位朋友嘅問題，然後即係睇下港仔有冇回應好嘛？
爭取同性戀、雙性戀同埋跨性別人權嘅一個團體。咁過去幾年咧，我哋其中一個主要工作就係爭取家暴條例嘅修訂。咁所以我哋對於家暴嘅各式各樣嘅問題，我哋非常之清楚。我諗對於同志朋友嚟講，如果我哋冇錢買樓或者租屋住，我哋終身都喺度貧窮喺香港嘅婚姻制度之下。咁所以我哋正正就係有好大嘅一班人家庭暴力條例並唔能夠保障。遇到前面的問題，所以某程度上都可以話，其實我哋需要一條前面法。咁但係聽完今日講咗好多好多 point， 我都寫低咗，但係我都想最後問多一次，即係因為我哋女同盟本身都係一個經常出席遊行示威嘅常客嚟，咁所以我亦都好驚遲早翻係廿三條嘅分離題一個分題。咁所以我想最後再問多一次，或者譬如 Linda， 你可唔可以答到我啫？仲有冇啲乜嘢細節？仲有冇啲咩魔鬼細節我一定要睇咧？即如果我相對比較抱持嘅話，唔該曬。
我唔該，阿黃老師。
第一位嗰位聽眾，即係觀眾講嗰個問題。我同意嘅，即如果而家講嘅，其實頭先張都有講嗰個集體騷擾行為，而家政府加落去嘅嗰兩條，係得英國有嘅嚇。咁其他地方都冇啊，咁佢無啦啦加入嚟咧，呢個係好大問題，即係集體纏繞行為，或者係一個纏繞者去騷擾當名受害人，就係頭先張所講，就是、英國好多一啲可能遊行示威會被纏繞法所影響嘅咧，就係、是、嚟自呢兩部分。咁所以如果各位團體係都支持纏繞法係立法嘅話咧，就一定呢兩個就唔好贊成，即、就、係、是、爆呢、這個就係真係。就是大家或者記住，佢哋好關注嘅呢、這個都會好大嘅影響。至於你第二條問題咧，就如果我哋有咗纏繞法咧，其實你而家所講嗰種情況咧，就某程度上都真係針對得到，因為纏繞法其中一個要針對嘅就係嗰種收數或者追數嘅情況嚇。咁至於現時可以點樣做，我諗要留待會談之後，或者可能我可以再傾。至於阿 Connie 所講的問題就是我想到的呢，其實剛才我已經說了真的最關鍵的剛才說的集體騷擾的行為，這是一定的，即如果這個 exclude 了，即出了去的話呢，其實已經有一個相當的保障。第二就真的那個免責辯護那部分，這個因為我想可能真的要我們打開案件的人權律師呢，我們就會看到那個問題，因為那是牽涉程序上的情況，也是大家經常說的警察信不過那種的情況，因為你一將那些我們不想立的那些行為放在 defense 即辯護那邊，他就將整個責任 shift 了，調了去，就是個被告自己要去證明自己沒事，這個是很大問題。所以那部分呢，大家也是一定要即係捉緊佢咧，就係話點都好嚇，冇可能做唔到，因為我受到咧，即係政府嗰個建議出邊咧，佢有提到啦，其他國家有立纏繞法嘅嗰啲國家咧，佢哋都有提出一啲相關嘅豁免或者免責，即係話咧，有一啲國家咧，佢係將呢啲行為咧係豁免咗，唔係全部國家都淨係擺咗喺免責面，咁但係香港而家選擇擺喺免責面。所以我相信我們如果去看回已經有就住纏繞法立法的那些國家，是一定會找到有一些國家呢，它是將那些行為是豁免了的。其中一個我覺得是真的可以積極去考慮，就是我們叫正當或者恰當的記者新聞採訪的活動，就將它豁免了。你一豁免了的話，警察想都不想得。但當然它有一些真的過了火位的新聞採訪活動，它都依然可以被纏繞法去針對，而我個人嚟講，我覺得係應該嘅。 咁但係起碼我哋大部分大家都覺得唔應該喐嘅，唔應該搞嘅創科活動或者係一啲集會遊行言論自由嗰啲咧，其實就應該唔會俾呢條條例咧係捉得到。咁去到最後尾，其實我都想講就係因為而家香港喺如果我哋擺咗喺免責嘅時候咧，警察嗰方面嘅考慮我哋減低咗啦。另外一樣嘢就係話，當我哋去到法庭嘅時候咧，因為啱啱香港唔係啱啱香港啦，都有段日子啊。香港有一個終審庭嘅案例咧，就講得好清楚嘅，就係法輪功嘅案件。咁、那個案件叫做楊冠華，就講得好清楚，就係話無論喺警察做嘢定係法庭去處理呢類案件嘅時候，如果嗰條法例係去限制一啲嘅言論遊行、集會自由嘅嗰條條例咧，法庭同埋警察去處理嘅時候咧，佢一定要去考慮一個平衡。即係話呢一啲限制係咪一個合理嘅限制，定係呢個限制已經係出咗嗰條線？咁所以呢一個原則咧，其實我哋而家每一次喺做呢啲人權嘅案件入面咧，每一次都喺度同法庭講，法庭亦都知道呢個係香港好清楚嘅原則，係唔可以推翻嘅。咁所以呢個就係我頭先講嘅一個底線。咁但係當然啦，即係話詮釋嘅空間係依然有。所以我哋唯有就喺個法例嘅草擬嗰部分咧，係要盡量小心。我如果補充，
如果請問在座嘅講者有冇補充啊？就住頭先嗰兩位問題，咁係呢位婦女嚇，咁就呢位參加者灰先生嚇，咁因為時間嘅關係啦，咁呢一位咧就係最後一位嘅發言者。
不過我想問一問咧，就係、是對化工嗰、那個會唔會有影響咧？我發咧我係個媒體教練，不過都比較即係睇得多呢啲集會啊呢啲嘢咁。我就想問，譬如一個工會咁樣，可能佢哋有幾個人可能覺得啲工資唔合理咁樣，咁可以想叫啲同事一齊罷工，咁可能佢哋會覺得可能遊說係一個可以成功遊說到啲同事會罷工，咁可能佢哋唔止遊說一次嘅，咁可能揾幾次咁樣。咁呢個會唔會成為一個前兆咁樣？係啊，即係想問一問啲人，即係會唔會限制到啲工會遊說人哋去罷工嘅時候，會唔會俾嗰啲人可以，譬如俾老闆可以話，咦佢而家纏繞緊其他同事咁樣，即係會唔會有咁樣問題出現㗎嘛？唔該。
邊位講者想回應呢個問題？
我嚟之前都同一啲工會嘅人討論咗呢個問題，咁。簡單嚟講就係現行香港有一啲嘅法例係關於罷工或者我哋英文叫 picket line 嘅，即係話我搞個罷工，然之後我喺個公司門口整一條線，唔俾一啲唔參與罷工嘅人入去個公司嗰度。法律亦都有呢啲好多個案例嘅。咁現行咧係有一啲嘅法例咧係去作出個平衡㗎啦，已經都相對保守㗎。哇！俾你聽，即係唔係真係咁支持。即係罷工啊嗰啲咁當㗎啦，啲案例都唔係咁支持㗎啦，即係都幾保守。咁纏繞法咧，我可以話俾你聽咧，如果我哋剔除咗集體騷擾行為嗰兩大舊嘅嘢嘅話，剔除咗嘅話咧，唔會令到而家嘅關於罷工啊工會嗰啲活動咧係咁差咯，即係我只想咁講。咁你係話咁？好咗咧，好咗就要好咗就要搞下而家嗰條即係罷工嗰條條例啦，係啦。
唔該曬阿 Linda 咁就因為時間關係，我哋都已經 overrun 咗啦。咁咧就要喺呢度結束。其實今日咧即係聽到大家嗰個嘅取向咧，都覺得一個纏繞嘅一個法例咧係有需要嚇，但係而家嗰個即係諮詢文件入邊嘅好多嘅內容咧。就真係咧有好多個問題令到我哋疑慮，咁今日咧就幾位講者咧都係講咗好多嘅佢哋嘅睇法，同埋俾咗我哋啲方向同埋啟發。咁呢個咧都係需要大家咧繼續去研究嚇。咁樣就喺呢一度咧就多謝咁多位嘅講者同埋各位朋友嘅出席。咁最後咧亦都係非常重要嘅一位朋友啦，我想喺呢一度咧特別咧係感謝一下嘅。咁咧佢就係今日咧幫我哋負責咧即時傳譯嘅朋友，佢係咧莫淑娴小姐，咁咧係香港國際係國際特赦組織嘅會員，多謝阿莫小姐今日咁辛勞咧係義務咁同我哋做傳譯嘅工作嚇，我哋要大大嘅掌聲嚟多謝佢好嘛？好，咁咧就最後咧就都多謝。 謝各位。咁請你哋咧出去之前咧，就還翻啲耳機嚇，咁樣樣嚇，俾翻門口嗰度有人會收嘅啦。係，多謝各位。咁頭先有朋友有問題咧，關於啲追債法律嘅咧，可以留待會後咧就睇下阿 Linda 有冇時間。如果唔係，都可以揾翻婦女中心嗰邊嘅。唔該。